Hi guys, and welcome to another video. In the last episode, I didn't have all this stuff. In the last episode, we made this beautiful purple obsidian armor. And it's pretty good. But yeah, in the last episode, we didn't have all of this or this or that. So I actually recorded a video that ended up not having any audio, so we're going to scrap it, where I made this drill. This drill is from Actually Editions, so we needed to make several machines from Actually Editions in order to get it created. This is an energizer, and this is what charges the drill. So it's rechargeable, real nice. This here is an atomic reconstructor. You can throw things into it and it will convert them into different items. I'm not going to use that right now. And then over here, this is called an empowerer. And you put four items on these pedestals and then you put something in the middle and it will convert that into an empowered version of that item. I'm not going to get too much into the mod right now. I really am kind of annoyed at the fact that I didn't get the video recorded properly. Besides that, I also did a couple live streams. One of the live streams is where we set up this empowerer. The other one, I set up this AE system. So we have all of our items now stored in AE. And if we come in here, you can see that I've cleaned out this place significantly. So we no longer have any chests in here, and it's quite a bit larger on the inside. I've also expanded up here, although I was going to put the empower in here. It turns out it wasn't enough room in here, so I don't know what we'll do with that space. But yeah, that should be all the changes. Oh, I also created this enchanting table so that we could enchant some pickaxes. I got a Fortune 3 pickaxe. Actually, I have a couple of those, and I also have a Silk Touch. Silk Touch pickaxe, and the reason I don't have a diamond one is just I didn't have any diamonds at the time. The fortune was actually to help me mine some extra diamonds. So hopefully you guys are all caught up there, and hopefully I didn't miss anything important. Now, we have been after ender pearls, which I have, not elder pearls, ender pearls, which I have none of. We actually have now one, but I hunted for them overnight, for a few nights in a row and only came back with the one. So I think something that would be useful to us would be to get a looting sword. Right now I just have sharpness 4 on this sword, which is helpful but not super helpful. So I think our next goal really is to get looting. In order to do that, I'm going to need a few more levels. So I'll probably go mining. Yeah, are you guys all caught up? I think that's everything. Oh, really quickly, I did want to mention, let's come out here. This drill can take augments, and you can see I actually have a Fortune 1 augment in here. The reason we're doing the enderpearls is to get a Fortune 3 augment, so I no longer have to carry this iron pickaxe with me. So it would be nice to get that, and then eventually it would also be nice to get, here we go, it would be nice to eventually get these 3x3 and 5x5 mining augments. We just need more diamonds really for those, so we may focus on getting some of those as well in the near future. Actually, let me take a look. I think we're out of diamonds. Yeah, we don't have enough to really get started on that, so hopefully when I go mining down here we're able to find some more diamonds, and I guess we'll see how that turns out. All right guys, welcome back. So I got some diamonds and I also have some levels. Now, why did I need 3 levels for? Oh, right. Looting sword. I'd like to get looting on a sword. I'd like to get looting on this sword, to be honest, but I don't know. Ooh, this is a bad idea. I really shouldn't waste diamonds on this. I'm going to do it anyway. Doesn't matter. All right, so let's go ahead and craft up a new diamond sword, and let's see if we can get looting on this guy, because I really need looting. And I just need some lapis. Cool. So we'll see how this goes. Sharpness, soul stealer, unbreaking. Ah, not great. Not exactly what I was after. So I'm going to go ahead and store that, I guess. Actually, you know what? Diamond. I feel like uses. There was a... Oh, no way. Is this really a thing? Oh, so I wasted 3 levels and 3 lapis, but no big deal, because I can apparently turn my sword back into diamonds. That's awesome. Okay, so that's actually a decent way to handle it. We'll just grab our diamonds back. Oh, you know what I'm realizing? I really missed out on keeping that stick that I used. That's unfortunate. And you know what? I was looking in here, and I can build the Fortune 2 once I have 4 Ender Pearls. But I was looking here, and we can actually build the Silk Touch, I think, now. I think I have enough emeralds. I say that and watch emeralds. Yeah, I do have enough emeralds. It'd be nice if I had 9 emeralds, so I could just do this process once instead of 4 times. I may actually go mining and see if I can find an extra emerald so I can do that. Because otherwise, I have to do this process 4 times versus just doing it once, which, I mean, I guess it doesn't matter, but it does matter to me. But yeah, Silk Touch upgrade would be really nice to have. But anyway, I guess I'm going to go back mining and see if I can find one more emerald, because that would actually help us quite a bit. All right, guys, welcome back. So I've been mining like crazy, and I think... All right, I was after emeralds, so let's go ahead. I think we have everything that we need to get started with making the empowered emeralds that we need to make this Silk Touch upgrade. And so to make these, we're basically going to place a block of emerald in the center with grass, lime dye, slime ball, and an oak sapling. And I think the only thing I don't have... Oh, I do have shears. I just need to get a little bit of grass, unless I already have some. No, I don't. Okay. And that should be all we need. Just a piece of grass. Actually, let's grab a few just in case we end up needing them later. It's always nice to have some spares, right? And then we can create lime dye out of cactus, which I have just a tiny bit of cactus. I should probably plant some of this, but one should be fine for now. Let's go ahead and grab this guy out of here. We'll cook this up. Now we should just be able to combine this with bone meal, right, to create the lime dye. Cool. And so we have that, lime dye, emerald, slime ball. So we'll grab one of these, and that should be everything that we need. So let's go ahead and craft up the emerald block. And man, fortune is such a nice thing to have. I forgot how nice it was. So we'll go ahead and not place a torch there. Zap that. Grab our drill out of here. Cool. And should be able to go ahead and create this now. So slime ball, sapling, one of those, one of them. Just like that. And that should create us our... Oops, let's get a screenshot of that. F2, F2, F2. Come on, do your thing. Come on now. Oh, lag. Hello? Uh-oh. Did my game crash? This is not ideal. Java platform binary is not responding. That's great. All right, we'll see if this fixed our issue here. It restarted the game. I hate when the game crashes. It always gives me that like feeling of dread, like I'm going to lose my world. Hopefully that's not the case. Hey, it made it. Okay. All right, well, I'm glad I didn't have to go through that 4 times like I was originally going to have to do. Oop. A little bit of post-startup lag here. We should be able to get rid of the rest of this, though. And all right, so we have the Empowered Emerald, which we needed. I also need 4 Diamantine, which I can just make out of diamonds. I found several diamonds while I was down. It was really... I don't know. I got really lucky because I was getting really frustrated, and then towards the end, I just found a ton of stuff all in a row. All right, so we got 4 Diamantine crystals. Actually... Okay, I was just making sure I didn't have those already. And then we just need an advanced coil, which... Oh, I do have one. Nice. I wasn't sure if I did. So we should be able to go ahead and create this Silk Touch upgrade now. Oops, we gotta convert these first. Cool. There we go. Done and done. And now this has become a silk touch pickaxe, which is super nice, especially for mining down below, because it means I can make a longer trip since I won't be collecting a bunch of individual items. So that'll be nice. And then I have the fortune upgrade, and I still want to make the fortune too. It's just going to take a while because I need these ender pearls. That's the only thing that I'm waiting on. I actually have everything else in here that's required for that. So I'm just waiting on the ender pearls. So once I have 4 ender pearls, I'll be able to go ahead and make those. For now, I'm going to go ahead. Actually, let's toss this in here. I might as well hold on to it in there for now and get rid of this. So that's nice. We've got silk touch. We may want to go ahead and create this as well. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's power. Okay. Yeah, this is a problem. Let me pull this out of here so we can get our system back online. I bet it's from the... oh, maybe not. I was going to say, I bet it's from the drill recharging, but it looks like this guy's full. Yeah, once this guy refills, it should be fine. And we'll be able to access this again. Oh, you know what it is? It's these things, I bet. Because these things are all recharging still. Yeah, that's definitely what it is. Look, they're all still recharging. Okay. So, good to know that that's going to bring my system down every time I craft something. There we go. So, we'll grab that. So, we needed 4 diamonds. What else did we need? We needed 4 Inori crystal. That's fine. We can make those out of iron. And anything else we needed? Basic coil. So, quartz. Actually, let's go ahead and make, and then redstone. We should be able to convert all this at once. So if I just step back a bit here, toss these all out, should be able to zap them all at once. Nice. Cool. So let's go ahead and craft this stuff up. So we'll go ahead and create this first. We'll go ahead and create those 4. And then we'll do this guy. And then what does it take for the 5? Because I might as well do that too, right? So let's grab an iron block, and we'll go ahead and get that crafted up as well. All right, grab some snowballs, because we'll need those for the craft. Go ahead and craft up some gray dye. Take some stone to create a stone button. And we just need 1 piece of cobblestone. That should get us going on this. Oh, actually, we have to... really quickly, create an iron block and convert this in here with the button. And then convert this guy. Oh, actually, we're not going to convert it. We're going to just empower the whole thing. So put that, our button, gray dye, snowball, cobblestone. Oh, and hopefully my game doesn't crash this time because it did last time. It's probably going to drop the power out of my system again too. Hello? Oh, there it goes. All right, it didn't crash that time. Nice. All right, so we've got our empowered Inori block. All we do is pull that out into the crystals. What else did we need? 4 diamonds and an advanced coil. All right. So luckily, we actually have all the things we need. Cool. So let's convert these. All right, we should be able to create the 5x5 now. Let's go ahead and do that. And that. Nice. So now we can go ahead and mine a big 5x5 area in addition to silk touching it. So we should be really good to go on mining. So let's go test this thing out. All right, so we're down here. This is where I've been mining, and I've actually been mining down that direction, but I think what we're going to do is just make this tunnel go that way, right? Oh, yes. It's everything I've ever hoped for, and more. That's awesome. Oh, man, this is going to be so much better. Look how much stuff I already have. All right, so then I'll just turn this on so I can continue to put down torches. But really, this is going to make mining a ton easier. And, oh, man, that's super satisfying. You know, I may even go down a couple blocks. Let me see, because this is going to be... Y level 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Okay, so actually diamonds can appear on all of those. I may still go down 1 block just because I believe lava level's down here. But yeah, this is going to be super nice. So give me a little bit. I'm going to mine a little bit of this and see if there's anything else I can come up with that I want to do for the rest of the episode. Ooh. All right. So I didn't really get very far because I ran out of power. I mean, I guess this is a lot to mine out. I've got pretty decent inventory full of stuff, but I ran out of power, and that is going to be a major issue. So I'm going to have to create some of those upgraded batteries so I can hold them in my inventory and use them for a longer mining session. It would also be nice to maybe set up an automatic charging setup where I can throw the drill into a bag and it will automatically be sucked out and charged and put back into my inventory. That would be sort of a next step for it. But I think for now, let's see what it takes to get one of these upgraded batteries, because we already have a battery. But it's probably going to be not enough. So let's take a look here. So this guy holds 200,000 RF, and this guy holds 250,000. So that's actually going to give us almost double. But let's see what it takes to upgrade this. So this is a single battery. You can basically just add a battery onto it looks like. So that's a double battery. And then this guy is a triple battery. And this guy is a quadruple battery. Can you make any further? Yeah, you can make a quintuple battery that holds 2 million RF or crystal flux. I assume that's the same as RF though, which would be nice. And I think I have all the resources to actually get that done. Let's see, we just need iron and diamonds, it looks like. So I might try to go that route. Let me see how far I can get down that, how many layers of battery I can create. So give me a little bit to get some resources together, and we'll see how far we can go with it. All right, guys, welcome back. Now, I believe I have all the resources. We're gonna try to do this without, we're gonna try to do this in one take. Let's see if we can make it happen. I don't think it's gonna work out for me. I'm sure I'm gonna make some major mistake, but it's not gonna stop me from trying. So we need to convert all of these into the crystal blocks. Done. Oh, we need our drill back. Oh, I need to. Don't accidentally mine with those things in there. You'll create a big mess. All right, so we need to then take one of these and one of these. All right, we're gonna do the iron first because I'm expecting it to be cheaper. So we're gonna do. Let's see if we can clear some of this out. Button, cobblestone, snowball, gray dye. And in theory, that will get us that powered. So the next thing is going to be two clay, a clay block, light blue, and then the diamond. And that should get us the other one. So we'll see if this works out for us. Come on now. It takes a lot longer than I feel like it should. I feel like it should just suck the power dry and then be done with it. All right, so we'll go ahead and put the diamond, light blue, clay. Clay block, and we'll wait for this guy as well. All right, so we got our empowered diamonds, our empowered irons, or whatever they're called. They're not actually called diamond or iron, but that's fine. We got that, and then we also have these guys, and I do believe that's everything that we need to start stacking this. So let's actually, oh, we also need to take this guy out. And do this. So we have four of those. Oh, we also need. The one thing I forgot was the gold nuggets. So we should be able to convert that. And then we should be able to just start stacking batteries in here with different resources. So first off is just plain iron, just like that. Next is the empowered iron. And I think we can do this twice. So that's a triple battery. Here's a quadruple battery, and here is a, oops, hello, quintuple battery. All right, so that's our 2 million RF battery, and let's see, we cannot make a better battery than that. So this is going to take a very long time to charge. Let's finish charging this really quickly, and then let's charge this guy up. Oh my gosh, it sucked that thing dry instantly. That's crazy. The nice thing about this, we could actually make another one of these and use it as a very large battery bank because I believe this Energizer has an equivalent item. in actually editions that does the reverse. It can drain batteries, so you can actually just put one in there and power your base with it. But I do think that's going to do us for now. I'll probably have to wait a significant amount of time for this to charge, because eventually what it's doing now is it's going to drain this battery that we have up here, which you can see. Oh, it's already drained it. Okay, so it's drained that battery, and basically it's only going to be powering off of our intake, which is not much, as you can tell. So I am going to probably run that off camera, and I think that's going to be it for this episode. Now, I know this episode's kind of a little bit weird. Unfortunately, like, I had an episode created of me making this drill and setting up some of the actual edition stuff. I didn't get audio recorded, so sorry that you guys missed out on that, but hopefully you guys did enjoy this episode. I'm really having a good time with this mod pack. It's so much fun, and I hope you guys are enjoying it as well. If you guys are enjoying these episodes, please go ahead and leave a rating. Also, if you guys are interested in watching the live streams, because I'm planning on doing a couple live streams a week if I can help it. If you're interested in watching those, click the link in the description, or go to mixer.com/Jessassin, and that is where I'll be streaming at. It's a lot of fun, and I'd like to see you guys there. But anyway, that's going to be it for today. So thank you guys for watching, and I will see you guys next time.